Welcome to this week's episode. So, on this dive, I'm actually diving a wreck that's been passed down through generations of my family. My dad used to dive it before me, and it's actually his favorite wreck, according to him. It's a steel hull shrimp boat that sits in about 180 feet of water. It's a very interesting wreck. There's a lot of grouper there and snapper a lot of times, but the peculiar thing about it is there's actually sometimes tarpon on it, which for deep shipwrecks in this area, it's not really something you normally see. So that's one of the interesting aspects of it. But some of the other things though to deal with on the downside, there's a lot of predators here between Goliath grouper, Jewfish, and also a lot of sharks sometimes, and other predators that you gotta deal with. So that's the downside. But like I said, plenty of good fish, and usually just full of life, sometimes bait balls. So I hope you all enjoy this dive. So this is a pretty routine dive. This is the second day of a two-day trip, first dive of the morning, if I remember right. And basically, I try to start deep and then work shallower for the nitrogen buildup and everything. Dropping down now between these rainbow runners here. See a first shark right here. Looks like a bull shark. You can see these mutton snappers underneath me here. I don't want to shoot them first though, because I'll alert the other fish on top of the wreck. That species of snapper tends to enjoy the commotion more, so I can usually get them later a lot of times. As you can see, I land off the wreck here. The current pushed me a little bit, so I figure out which direction I need to swim. A lot of times I can follow these predators like this, and they'll lead me to it. See that shark go by right there? It's just a nurse shark now. Here's some bait piled up here too. I know when I get right up over this wreck here, I gotta act quickly. There's a grouper right there. First shot. I use the commotion here to my advantage. I know something's gonna come in, like this Cabrera. Second shot. Pull him in right before the Jewfish gets him. Watch my flank there. As soon as I go one direction, they'll come in from the opposite end. I watch these guys. Always waiting for an opportunity. If you notice, that gripper tried to head straight into the engine hole right here. Caught him just in time. They tend to do that here, especially when it's dirtier like this. If you don't shoot them right away in the split second that you have, they go down into the engine room and they're gone. I go down there myself, but can't even get in there even if I take my BC and tank off. You can see the hold in front of me. You can get down there, but for some reason, it's like they know it. They don't stay down there. I watch these shrimp nets everywhere. Fishing line, rope, and shrimp nets. This wreck has it all. Most of the group are most likely went into the engine room by now. But there's a couple other spots I still can check. There's one. Another one down. See all the shrimp nets off the front of the boat right here. Or stern, I should say. Checking the cabin now. This guy will scoot over. See the room is down there, the engine room. It's too tight to get into. The bow of the boat right here. See all the lionfish. Set now. Sending the fish up for my boat to grab. Thank you. that's a wrap. Nothing insane by any means, but it's a couple hundred dollars. Quick start. Nothing too out of the ordinary. A little bit of action in the beginning there, but overall, worthwhile dive. Thanks for watching. Tune in next week for more. And thank you for Destination Now for helping put this video together and helping prepare the edits. So hopefully have more footage for you guys soon now that I have a little help with piecing everything together. Thank you.